Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
My name is Greg Edwards, and I have lived in the Lehigh Valley for 25 years. I am 48 years old. I've been married for 25 years. I have four children, and they are all at the house, thank the Lord. And I am a native of New Jersey, and I graduated from Geneva College with a Bachelor of Science in Urban Planning, a Master's in Philosophy and Theology, and a Doctorate degree in Public Policy and Transformative Justice from New Brunswick Theological Seminary. So I pastor a church that I founded 20 years ago in Allentown, Pennsylvania, called Resurrected Life Community Church. It is a racially diverse, inclusive congregation that's very involved in the community, very involved in community organizing. I was the former board chair of Power Northeast, which is a PICO affiliate. And so I spent the majority of my life doing community organizing. And I'm really running because in my 48 years, I have never witnessed what we are witnessing in the nation right now. I mean, this, you know, we were a nation that elected post 9/11 a guy by the name of Barack Hussein Obama with a Kenyan father and a white woman who was his mother from Kansas. And then we also elected Donald J. Trump. So we are a nation that has given birth to a Barack Hussein Obama and a Donald Trump. And I think that we are at a decisive moment that we have to stop fence walking and define what kind of nation we're going to be. Unfortunately, most of America now is not looking like the majority of this room. The nation is changing. And the Democratic Party, unfortunately, many times fails to get that right. The only way we win is by building a big canopy and making sure that we render no person invisible because of their race, their gender, their orientation, or their social class. The Democratic Party has lost 1,500 seats since 2008 because we continue to run on a platform based upon what America used to think and look like versus where America is going. And that's very problematic. So we should not be politicizing healthcare. Healthcare should be a cornerstone of our democracy. Healthcare should be a right, not an entitlement. But there's a lot of dog whistling happening in Washington, D.C., where the notion of anything that is public really is a sense of entitlement. So if it's a public school, it really shouldn't be for all. It should be for folks who deserve it. So the word public is being dog whistled as an entitlement. And of course, if you start dividing people and dividing spaces and groups like that, there's some folks who ought to get services and some folks who ought not to get services. So we ought to have absolutely universal health care. We can pay for it. We have the way to pay for it if we close some loopholes. We ought to also have equitable funding for all of our public education. We know that that's a state's issue, but the fact of the matter is we keep sending folks to Congress who are legislating and concretizing inequity. Your zip code should not determine the quality of life you live. And I don't think now is the time for moderation. Now is the time for bold, courageous vision. We are running around the halls of Congress doing demonstrations to get back basically a flawed ACA. Because we should have pushed for universal health care to begin with. So there's something in us that says we don't deserve the whole piece of the pie. We really should just be happy with the crumbs. So now is not the time for that. Now is the time for us to really take a stand, stop fence walking our faith, our values, and really begin to define what does it mean to be a Democrat. You know, as we've already heard, you know, the Democratic Party is the party of Social Security. Of Medicaid, of putting a person on the moon. So we can't run in 2018 just being anti-Trump. We have to create a vision for what kind of America we want to be. And so I'm running because I think now is the time for us to get behind the right folks to run and say push to lead in and push folk into a new way of being America. And right now we have a republic. We don't have a democracy. And it's moving towards oligarchy. I mean, that's what we're moving towards. And if we think that that's not happening, we are fooling ourselves. It's bad. And now we have an opportunity. We did in 2017, a few weeks ago, what I never thought we would do, by electing folks in office who never would have ordinarily been on the ballot. And now is that time. Now is the time for us to stop fence walking. Now is the time for us to be decisive in who we put in Congress. So that's why I'm running. I want to thank you all. It's been good to be here.